G'day guys, Graeme here. Doing a bit of a hike today up in the mountain, and got to do a bit of a camp out tonight and try out a bit of my gear. I've got a portable super shelter, and I'm going to do hopefully a long overnight upside down fire that'll keep me nice and warm instead of get down really cold tonight. Last night up here we had 100 kilometre hour winds and 4 inches of rain, so everything's pretty wet. So hopefully we can get the fire going all right. I've got a bit of a tarp shelter to put up also. Hopefully keep the fire nice and dry. So we'll get started, so bear with me and let's get going. So this is my homemade super shelter, just made out of a bit of a tarp and a bit of clear plastic, heavy duty plastic though. I found that a few of the ones that I've seen on YouTube, they seem to use very, very thin. But where I go hiking and camping, it's fairly windy and I don't think they'd hold up too well. This particular campground where we're at, it's a big rock base here, so I've got to use actually rocks to pin it down. It's very hard to drive a tent peg in. Came up to this spot last week and had a bit of a go at it. It was quite cold that night too. But I was having a bit of trouble with my camera that camp out, so couldn't do a hell of a lot. I used some hiking poles just to push the back of the super shelter out a little bit, just to give me a little bit more room. Okay, so there's the super shelter set up. Doesn't take very long. I just use a little bit of Gorilla Tape on these edges here overnight just to stick it together a little bit there, but you want a bit of flow, a bit of the airflow, otherwise it just gets too hot in there. But so what I'll do now is I'll just put this over the back and we'll get the tarp set up. And I'll just show you inside there for a minute. Okay, there. So there's the complete setup with a super shelter and the tarp, and you can see how it just overhangs the fire there. So in case it rains, yeah, we should be right, I think. What we'll do now is I'll get a bit of wood going, get the fire going. Now I've already cut up a little bit. Everything's really wet, so
quite sure how we'll go.
I had one of these fires going last week, and it lasted about 14 hours, and there was still plenty left to cook breakfast on, so
I was quite happy.
It's a little bit more work setting it up, but then it's you just forget about it then. Okay, I'm going to try and get this fire started now. I'm not all that confident tonight, everything's so wet, but we'll give it a go anyway. Everything is so wet. Let's put a bit of plastic down.
Back a little bit. A bit of luck. Whew.
Oh no. Tell me. No. Couldn't quite get her. Oh. I really thought I had that. Thank you.
It might be in luck. Yep, I think we'll be right. It's just starting to glow now. Okay. Even that grass is a little bit. Certainly is a lot harder to do this in the wet. Well, that was touch and go. For a minute there, I didn't think I was going to get it. But I'll just have to build this up slowly now so I can cook my tea on it. Steak for tea tonight.
So it's going to take me a little while to get this going. I suppose when you get 4 inches of rain overnight,
it's going to make it a bit difficult. But that's starting to come along nicely now. Now, while I'm waiting for that, I might get my bedding organised. Time to cook some tea. Always like my veggies. Nice bit of steak. That'll do.
Ah, that's looking good. Always nice to have a nice meal at the end of the day. What I'll do after I finish tea, I'll just stake this up a little bit and spread those coals right along the length of that upside down fire. And then it's just forget about it for the night. It should just burn all night, just at a nice pace. It doesn't flare up like a normal fire, so that's what I like about it. Especially when you're inside there in the super shelter, otherwise you can get a bit too warm. Nice if it's about 23, 24 degrees Celsius. Couple of nice potato scallops. Actually, it's really starting to cool off now. So I think I'll be just getting tea cooked in time and get this fire stoked up. Right-o. All right. Well, let's have a look at this. Whoa. Beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. Well, how nice is this, eh? Sitting back here in this beautiful spot in the forest. It's getting very cold, but I can already feel that little bit of warmth now, so I'll finish tea and I'll get it staked up again and then we can relax. There we go, I've just stacked it up a little bit. It's going to take a little bit of time to get going, but it's going to burn quite nicely, I think. And I'll, before it's starting to get dark now, so I'll just give you a bit of a look around the super shelter and the tarp setup. And there's the view from the back of the shelter. So it's great for keep, if it does rain, it certainly keeps it all off you. Gives you somewhere to sit too around the fire of a night while you're waiting to go to bed. So it's been going just over an hour now. So it'll easy go through to the morning. And the wood's a little bit damp, so it'll probably burn a little bit slower tonight. That's burning really nice. You can see that I've got the little rock wall there at the back, just to reflect that heat back. That's looking great. It's nearly 7 o'clock now, and so that's about 2 hours it's been going for. It's burning nicely now. And the temperature's dropping very quick. Actually, there's some fine mist now. So I'm glad I've got the tarp up tonight. I won't bother dropping the front of the super shelter down until I'm ready to retire for the night. It's quite nice just to sit in there and look at the fire. So my bedding's all ready for the night now. Okay, I don't know if you can see that, but it's 23.6 degrees Celsius in the super shelter, and it's 0.9 degrees Celsius outside. I'll just flick it over to Fahrenheit. If you can see that, a bit hard to read. 74.7 degrees Fahrenheit inside and 33.6 degrees out. Nice and warm. I'll just put it back to Celsius. Twenty-three point eight and 0.8, yeah. And it's about 9:10, so the fire's been going for about just over 4 hours. There we go. Burning very nice. G'day guys, I got a great sleep last night. It's about 7 o'clock now this morning, so that's about, 14 hours the fire's been going. I never had to use my sleeping bag last night, I've just slept in my long sleeve shirt, my jeans. It pretty much rained all night actually, from about 11 o'clock I suppose. Just light rain all night with lots of wind, it's about -3. So it wasn't very nice conditions to be outside, but I was very glad I had the tarp set up and kept the fire nice and dry, and it's still going quite well. It's about 22 degrees in here still. So yeah, I think all in all it's worked out pretty good. Anyway, I'll show you the fire. So yep, so you still got a few hours left, I'd say. Oh, I'd say at least 3 hours left. It's almost 14 hours now, so yeah, there's a 17-hour fire for you. The tarp certainly helped though, keep all the rain off the fire. It's just light rain, just that misty rain. So I'll pack up in a minute and get going. Alright, time for a bit of breakfast. Might as well make the most of this fire. Nice bit of bacon and sausages. Looking beautiful. Oh, I think that's just about ready. Bacon and eggs and sausages. Alright guys, hope you've enjoyed this little camp out. I've certainly enjoyed it, and I think it's worked out pretty well for me considering the conditions. So we'll hopefully see you again next time.